You should care about the indigenous people of America and the centuries-old knowledge that we keep. Before we take it to the grave, the little that we hold, the little was so precious, so rare, and so pure. Conquerors only had eyes for the gold. But it's all we have left, our lands. Now we can never return. You call this saved? You got the gold, the oil, the fertile virgin soils. What more could any man ask for? All the riches in the world can't free your souls. I saw the beautiful bosom of our well-kept gardens. I struck straight through to take the heart of the land. Veritable Eden, veritable Eden, veritable Eden. They even put the original people in the original Holocaust camp. Such that has never been known to these lands. There was no such words among our people.
No such words among our people.
So many of our knowledge holders were targeted and eliminated through systemic genocidal policies devised through the minds of the Calvaries and approved by the Congress of the 1800s. They scorched the earth and crossed every line, made illiterate people sign X's on lines to strip away the rights and make legal contracts to inherit the ancestral lands.
We remain.
Trying to pick up the fragments, trying to repair the trauma and the pain. We do not seek revenge, nor seek your deathly ends, lords of the 1900s. We only desire to restore such values as harmony and balance to the world as it was once before.
These are the central teachings that guide us.
That govern our communion with the natural world. Synchronicity, the natural symphonies of life and death.
They told you it was all connected. They told you to respect it.
Our heroes, though now taken, speak through us. Through their eyes and photographs, through our own eyes, and in our dreams. What has manifested from those strange flames, invoked not by the savages of the Wild West or Eastern Plains, not from the people of Turtle Island or the First Nations, not by the hand of indigenous stewards.
When was it enough?
Why hasn't it stopped? Our people served and got mixed in the smelter, but something's still off.
It's no longer she has no master.
Just a strange hive of honeypot-banking bastards. Profiteers playing with people's lives. Political puppets or runners or wizard-worded hexes on the public. First spoken to the fires in the forests at night.
The trees have eyes.
If you never saw it before, it's okay. It only takes a little to jolt you from the cast. We have a common enemy. Greed and poverty, indignity, and oppression is still going on
in this 21st century.